Hey guys, Half-Click Up here. If you change the factory gear ratio on your Yamaha FZ6R, you are going to have to recalibrate the speedometer because your speedo will be off as well as your odometer reading. We have opted to cure that situation with the 12 o'clock Labs SpeedoDRD. Now the unit you're going to need for pretty much all modern metric sport bikes is the SDRD-Y1 unit. Now you can see all the models listed here that this actually covers, and it's quite a few. And what makes this unit awesome is that it's literally plug and play. Now the way this works is it simply piggybacks on your speed sensor. So you're going to unplug your speed sensor and simply plug this in between. Now that means that this unit here is what's going to ride between your ECU and your speed sensor. This is programmable. You see there's one little button there. That little button does all the things. We'll cover all that here in a minute. But first, we have to locate our speed sensor, right? Now if you're doing a mod like this, you're probably already familiar with the fact that you have to get to the wiring harness. And we run a PCFC fuel controller there. And so it's all meshed into the wiring harness here. Now, luckily, in this application, you don't even have to mess with your fuel controller's connections. The speed sensor is not even tapped by the fuel controller. So, get our light here. If you get on the left side of the bike, get up here above the shifter linkage, look inside right there. See those three wires? That's going to your speed sensor. Now those three wires are sheathed in that little black rubber you see there, and it runs up, coming around the right side of the bike. That is this guy here. See, it runs all the way down there to where we were just looking. You can follow it to inside this rubber sheath here, and it's that guy right there. See him? Give it a tug. See how it's that one single wire that runs all the way down to that speed sensor. So all we're gonna do is disconnect this guy and piggyback our 12 o'clock Labs SpeedoDRD unit right onto there, and just organize our wires a little bit with the included zip ties. Here we go. All right, again, so it's this guy inside this rubber sheath. If you turn that connector over, there is a little tab you can press right here. Now, there's only one way for this to work out. Makes it pretty easy. It's a triangle, so, you know, little guy goes in little guy. And then big guy goes into big guy. And that's all there is to it for installation, folks. It simply piggybacks the speedo sensor. Now we're just going to tuck this stuff inside that rubber. And we are going to use the zip ties that came with it. And we're just going to dress this up a little bit. But never mind that. Let's get to the programming. Of course, prior to programming the unit, you have to calculate your correction percentage. Now, 12 o'clock Labs on their website has a calculator for doing just that. I took a screenshot of the results for mine, but I'll also show you how to manually do it according to their instructions. But anyways, you can see here I inputted a GPS reading of 60 miles an hour. My speedo was indicating 72. You calculate that and it tells you your correction percentage is negative 16.7% for my particular application. Using the speed of the GPS device, the formula is your GPS speed divided by your speedo readout times 100 and then minus 100. So that would be 60 miles an hour divided by 72 miles an hour equals times 100 equals minus 100 equals bam, negative 16.7%. There you go. All right, so we're gonna do it right and actually go through the entire process, which begins with a test mode. And so we're gonna turn on the bike. We won't start it, but we'll turn it on, and we should get a red-green flash on the SpeedoDRD, on the module. And it says if it doesn't flash red or green, then we've got it plugged into the wrong sensor. So first things first, let's make sure we're good and we're live. So we're gonna turn the bike on. We're looking for a flashing red-green for confirmation. There it was. Here, I'll do it one more time. Try and get a different light. Ready? Red, green. All right, so to continue the test, hold the white button for 8 blinks, then release. That selects test frequency mode. The LED blinks while test frequency is generated. Pressing again will increase the test frequency. You can press the button up to 8 times for 8 levels. Check the speedometer between button presses. Once you have a reading on the speedo, turn the ignition key off. If you still don't get a reading, you have it plugged into the wrong sensor. Well, I think we've already established that it is plugged into the right sensor. It's kind of hard to screw that up on this bike, guys. But we'll go ahead and go through it anyways, just so we can say we did it. So hold the white button for 8 blinks, then release. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, there's our test mode. So, press it once, twice, 3 times. There it is, showing 5 miles an hour. So there's our signal, guys. We did it right. There you go. I'm still pressing the button. Right, they say you can press it up to 8 times. There you go, she's live. All right, we're good to go. All right, so next step, SpeedoDRD programming. Perform a factory reset to make sure you are starting fresh. That makes sense. So we want to go ahead and clear out whatever might be in there from the factory. All right, so here's a sequence on how to do that. We're going to turn the ignition on. We're going to hold the button for 10 blinks. That'll put us at the reset menu. Then we will hold the button again until we get orange. And then we're gonna release it. So you release when it turns orange, and that'll clear everything factory reset. That's what we wanna do. After reset's complete, LED will give an orange flash, let you know it was good to go. All right, so we're going to hold for 10 flashes and then release. That puts us in programming mode. And then we're going to press it again and release when it turns orange. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Programming mode. Hold and release on orange. Oh, that's orange. And then the confirmation. Yep, that's it, guys. Just like that. It's factory reset. All right. All right, so we want to hold the button for 5 blinks to enter that setup mode for correction percentage input. And then you simply hold down for the number you need to correspond with. So ours is negative 16.7. So we're going to press the button again once we're in the programming mode, and that will show the colors will release on red in order to input a negative number, and we'll go from there. So let's start out by going into programming mode. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There it is. Release on red. There it is. Okay. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's our 16, our negative 16. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And the orange confirmation. Negative 16.7% has been inputted. And that is all there is to it, boys and girls. All right, so obviously the next steps is just to button her all back up and go for a test ride and see if that percentage calculation is what makes her happy. We'll do that by running the GPS speedo on my iPhone at the same time we're cruising, and we'll compare and see if that correction percentage balances that out to where the GPS indication is the same as the speedometer indication. Well, that's pretty damn close right there. 60 on 60. Let's go. All right. Now we're more accurately gauging. 80 miles an hour is 85 or 8600. We'll say 8600 RPM. If you have any questions, drop a comment down below, obviously, as always. Now, pro tip, in case I have to get back to this guy, right, like access him again, I'm gonna make sure and route this booger up underneath here and into the battery tray area. I'll remove this cover and run it in there. That way I have quick and easy access to it to make any kind of programming changes I need to make without having to go through all this trouble of lifting the tank again. And so that's what I'm going to do, and that'll be all there is to it. Again, guys, if you enjoy this technical content, smash the like button, subscribe if you haven't already. Check out the little thanks button down there, the little heart. Press that, see what it does. As always, guys, I'll catch you in the next one. It's been me, that's been you. Peace and a goodbye.